sports. It's in the game.
Nobody blocking, big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner of your limbs, getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk on.
Future home of Super Bowl 56. There's a look at SoFi Stadium just south of downtown Los Angeles.
Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Los Angeles Chargers. The first game's out of the way. Time to buckle down for the long season ahead, and we're off in week two.
This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down. This defense for the Jags, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Herbert will give this one to Ekeler. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Well, that is a running back who was not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
Yeah, and this could be a sign of what this defense is in for, because, you know, all week long the coaches were preaching to the defense, you've got to be able to wrap up against a back like him, or he can make you pay. Technique, technique, technique.
Running on first down, Eckler. The tackle there by John Johnson.
No doubt about it, a really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Here's Herbert. Escaping the pressure right. Got an open man. It's Josh Palmer. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 40. A little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play, and gave up a bigger one instead.
And a pretty good run there as he gets seven down to the 33. So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three.
Second and three at the Jaguars' 33-yard line.
On the give, this is Eckler. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
They'll try the right side with Eckler. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Juwan Smoot there to bring him down.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They'll try the air now with Herbert, eluding the pressure right. He's got a man, that's Keenan Allen. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 18.
First drive of the game. We did see this in practice, didn't we? Because they allowed us to stay and watch and see what their opening script would be, even though we don't know the exact play calls. That looks a lot like what we saw them execute, doesn't it?
It really does. And in practice, it wasn't about a lot of big shots on that opening drive. They wanted to put together a series of plays, sustain it. They've done that. The defense now on their heels a little.
That they are. And you know what else is happening now? They're gaining information. They're gaining knowledge about how the defense is planning on playing them. So not only are they being successful on this drive, they're filing things away for future drives in this game.
And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second and nine, Herbert. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And they're going to have a third down. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Flushed out right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Matt Judon able to finally wrestle him down for what's just going to be a huge loss. And it takes us to fourth down as well. A field goal gets him closer, but they say no thanks. We want the lead. Here we go on fourth. Herbert. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The fourth down play doesn't work for the Chargers. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw, Lawrence. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They go play action now. Lawrence. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And he takes it all the way down to the 3. A big play there on the catch and run.
I tell you, for a defender, that's got to be a scary sight, seeing a big man like this with a head of steam behind him as he makes that catch and then turns upfield.
And I think this is what the early proponents of the forward pass were thinking about. Get it to a receiver and have him do some work afterwards in order to create the big play we just saw there.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Leads to second and goal at the 3-yard line.
They turn to the fullback, Gillespie. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. This Charger defense continuing to hold the line. Now it's a third and goal situation. Lawrence on the sneak, and he'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. Trevor Lawrence, his third touchdown now on the year, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. And this is up and good. The score now 7-0 Jaguars.
That's the score, Jaguars 7, Chargers nothing. Logan Cook to kick off for the Jaguars.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Charger drive about to get going.
They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy.
Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. On first down, it's Herbert. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Options galore here, second and a few inches. From the 50, here's Herbert. That's into the hands of Eckler. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. This will wind up a loss on the play, and that is going to set up a third and one. Again, Herbert. And that is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
To punt on fourth down, here's Rigoberto Sanchez. Jamal Agnew is deep to return it. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Lawrence from his end zone. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he gets this up just shy of the 15.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
So still backed up, but the situation not as dire now. First and 10 at the 14. Now Lawrence to throw. He'll air this one out for Kirk. This is intercepted. Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
A give, Eckler running to the right. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Back to throw here, Herbert. He'll drop this one off to Eckler. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Herbert now. Going deep here for Allen. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
Here's second and 10. Now it's Herbert. Right back for Allen. This time he finds him complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 21. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit. And that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions. Even when you're taking some hits, sometimes you have to be your own blitz control, for lack of a better term. Got to make completions, step up and make those throws, and he did that.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. Second and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Herbert. Now into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the Jaguars are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
It's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. But that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short.
By Derwin James. 10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. On second and very short, Lawrence. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Lawrence on third down. And Ingram hauls it in.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
That's a big conversion there on third down because they did not want to give the ball up here late in the half. They'd love to take the clock all the way down and score. This will definitely help the cause.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. From the shotgun, Lawrence finding some room at midfield. He gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. First and 10, it's Lawrence. Going deep for Hopkins. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I'm sure that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. And that's complete ETN out of the backfield. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 33.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
And they'll try and set up the screen to ETN. First down and more, ETN. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. He let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space, the big guys leading the way.
Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Touchdown, Jaguars! Travis Etienne, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead. Extra point good by Hopkins. And that'll make the score 14 to zip.
14, Chargers nothing. Logan Cook to kick off for the Jaguars.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. This is swung out to Eckler. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
So we've reached halftime here with the visiting Jaguars out on top as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Both these teams no doubt making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Gunn and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number 3.
Greg Zuerlein set to kick off.
The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the second half. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit.
Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. The 20, touchdown, Jaguars.
So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates. They're looking at you. And let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to him. That's not how football works, but he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. They're down three touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it first and 10. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon. Mike, 53.
Eckler going to get it again on second down.
And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach? When I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Herbert off of play action. It's Williams on the catch.
And he is going to have the Chargers first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down, and that's what he just did.
On first down, Justin Herbert. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Wide open, it's Allen, complete. Touchdown! Keenan Allen, 50 yards! And the Chargers, they're able to cut into that deficit. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. To return, here's Agnew. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Play action. It's Lawrence. Flush to his right. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Lawrence going to keep it again, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Tackle made there by the safety, Derwin James.
But that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Here's Lawrence. And looking for Kirk, but this pass is intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Jackson. Pass the 20. And he brings this one back. It's a pick 6 and a Charger TD.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? And off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Zuerlein good with a PAT, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. To return, here's Agnew. Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
And what a return. Great field position all the way out to the 48 there.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
So they will tread backward on the holding penalty.
And I know that they're going to get coached up and they'll get yelled at a little bit, but let's face it, it is hard not to do at the speed and pace that they play.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He'll find ETN out of the backfield. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a big play, yet amazingly, because of how far they had to go, they're still looking at a second down here. And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. And give him about four on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
Third and inches, they just hand it to the big battering ram there. That's football 101, isn't it? That's bread and butter. Turn around, hand it to the big fella, and let him get forward for a first down.
As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Lawrence to throw. This is Chenault on the receiving end. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
On first and 10, it's ETN. And able to get about three as he's taken down right at the 20.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Now Lawrence. Touchdown, Jaguars! DeAndre Hopkins, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jaguars are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Here's Hopkins now for the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14.
28, Chargers 14.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return.
And he gets it to the 30-yard line, but the football's not going to stay there. There's a penalty marker down. So holding will scratch off some of that return.
And I know fans get frustrated when they see penalties of this sort on kick returns, but it is difficult to do it right against these moving targets at full speed. Hard to do.
So the hold on special teams backs him up all the way inside the 15 to start. On first down, it's Herbert. He's going to look for Allen now, the deep ball. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. That's caught right side by Palmer. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line.
First and 10.
Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Josh Palmer, the intended target, but it'll be second down. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. For whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. He's got Allen. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
The Chargers on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They're looking at third and a few inches. Here's Herbert. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Coverage was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Fourth down for Herbert. Desperation time. And Allen's got it. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Herbert on first down now. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6 at the Jaguars' 49-yard.
Herbert throwing again. Escaping the pressure right. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack. And it's third down. Herbert now. Oh, this will be incomplete.
The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. They snap it to Herbert. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, now he'll try and chuck it deep left side. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. Try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for 4-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Yeah, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it, and let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
check me out. I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn. They tried to count me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. From the view, got my check up, and now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud to shoot, and all designer, drink it what I desire. Put them